Hello, my name is Andrea Molnar and I'm currently a lecturer at University of Portsmouth in United Kingdom. I started working on DIA2, which stands for Deep Insight Anytime, Anywhere, when I was a postdoctoral researcher at Arizona State University. DIA2 is a project funded by National Science Foundation, and it is a collaborative effort between Arizona State University, Purdue University, Stanford University, and George Mason University. DIA2 is a data mining and web-based platform that uses metadata about funding information from the NSF to produce interactive data visualization. It provides an overview of the NSF portfolio in an easy-to-understand format, allowing users to search, view, and analyze the NSF funding portfolio. The high-volume nature of funding data is often disconnected and diffuse. As a result, deriving meaningful insights from an existing funding portfolio is challenging. Issues arise not only in data representation, but also in the way data is accessed and communicated to end users. Enabling users to see relationship gaps and other connections could lead to new insights that can facilitate a better overview of existing funding research and more informed decision-making for future funding. However, the gap between data visualization and actual insights can be difficult to bridge. In this study, we attempted to determine how visualization provided by DIA2 leads to insights that can facilitate further decision-making, such as estimates about the impact of specific research projects. We presented the results regarding the usability of DIA2. What differentiates us is that most of the existing studies have focused on how to design better visualization of the NSF portfolio or on the usability of a certain visualization technique. We are looking into how visualization might lead to insights about the impact. We show several ways in which DIA2 can be an effective tool for defining, measuring impact at the institution, project, and individual level, but we also show that the impact of the research is complex and difficult to operationalize. We also found that DIA2 has a good usability, but also shows some limitation of existing visualization techniques when large data is displayed. DIA2 has been refined based on the user feedback obtained as a result of the study. We performed user study with project investigators to better understand the insights that can be derived from DIA2. This study are currently under analysis.